Hello. So in this video I'm going to run through my new power brake controller I've made for train sim and train sim world. So I'm going to run through the hardware, show you what's what, go through the software a bit and then do some driving. The actual combined power brake controller is styled on a class 377, you may recognise that, but in fact it actually works equally well on a variety of different trains I've tested it on. Here's the list I've tested it on so far. It's got three main parts to it. It's got the master key, which pops out, as you can see. It's got the reverser switch with different clicky positions, and also the actual power and brake handle. The master key doesn't work very well with most locos, so I'm actually thinking I'm not bothering with that. I might change it myself for an AWS plunger. In terms of the hardware itself, it's a pretty sturdy unit made of plastic and metal on the top, and it just plugs in via USB. It weighs around 1.8 kilos, so it's fairly heavy and sticks to the desk nicely. Most important bit, of course, is the power brake handle itself. So this has the common four notches for brakes, and the fourth notch is a bit stiffer because it's the emergency one, which is kind of true to life. And then it's got a total of seven notches for power. Most trains have four. The Siemens Desiros have five, and a few DMUs have seven. So it works kind of equally well over all of them. There's a choice of three handles for this controller. You've got the typical chunky Electrostar and Turbostar style handle. Then you've got the Siemens Desiro style handle, class 350, 450, etc. And then you've got a nice round ball for the Pendolino 390. So a quick introduction to the software itself. So this software here is basically the interaction between the physical controller hardware and the train sim software itself. So it's basically just runs in the background when you're using the controller. It pretty much sets itself up, but there's a few different features you can use if you need to. For example, it tells you the what controller modes is programmed in at the moment. So the controller, the physical hardware controller, needs to be programmed differently for train sim and train sim world, but that's straightforward. Which notches the controller mode is in. Some locos it switches automatically to the correct notches, but other locos you need to say it's a 4-notch, 5-notch or 7-notch power. And when train sim's running, it tells you what the loco is and information about that, and also some other parameters to make it more customizable. Settings, you can just different settings there, test settings, reprogramming the software. So the actual hardware controller itself is quite programmable, so I can provide updates to it, customizations to it, because there's actual software inside the controller itself, as well as the software that's based in Windows. So each time you load a new loco or unit into train sim, the controller software reads the parameters from train sim software itself and then adapts the controls to work correctly. The only thing it doesn't do automatically on every loco is decide whether it's a 4, 5 or 7 notch unit. So when we change to a different unit, the controller software realizes this and lets us know what mode the controller is in at the moment, and then gives us the option to change it if we want. So this is a 7-notch loco.